Enough variety. Hij werd bekend met hits als Sultans of Swing, Brothers in Arms, Walk of Life en Private Investigations en nog veel, vele andere. Zijn gitaar is zijn passie, zijn muziek zijn handelsmerk. Mark Knopfler, zanger, componist en gitarist van de Dire Straits. Maar nu heeft hij die band even verlaten en staat hij alleen op het podium. En heeft hij een officiële solo CD, Golden Heart. Hij is op tournee in Nederland en Nieuwslijn's Variety sprak met deze koning van de gitaarrock, Mark Knopfler.
Het is even wennen, zo zonder de Dire Straits, zonder haarband en alweer wat jaartjes ouder. Maar hij is het toch echt, herkenbaar aan zijn gitaarspel en herkenbaar aan de stem. Mark Knopfler. Voor het eerst echt solo op tournee, met zijn nieuwe cd Golden Heart. Maar de vraag is waarom? Waarom voor jezelf beginnen als het vorige muzikale leven zo succesvol was?
Well, it's just the way it worked out. I had some songs that I wanted to do with different musicians. So I did. I went to Dublin, did some there. I went to Nashville, did some there. Took me all over the place.
Golden Heart staat boordevol met nieuwe nummers. Nummers geschreven die hij altijd alleen wilde spelen. Het is dan ook een cd die Knopfler zelf erg goed bevalt.
I can listen to it. I didn't used to be able to listen to records that I made before, but I can listen to this one. I mean, I like playing the old stuff live, you know. But I don't like going into a bar and hearing it particularly.
Why not?
I don't know, I was thinking, it always seems to me that I could have done it better.
Would you see yourself as a perfectionist?
No. There's no such thing. It's just a cloud in the air. Perfection doesn't exist. It's the attempt is what it's in.
Perfectionism is 100%. What stage did you reach now?
22, maybe 21, 22.
Not that more?
No, I think if you can get, you know, if you can get into the twos, you're probably doing pretty well.
Het is duidelijk, de muzikant Mark Knopfler is verre van tevreden over zichzelf. Hij zegt nog steeds te leren, ondanks het succes en meer dan 20 jaar ervaring. En als er iets is waar hij onzeker over is, dan is het wel zijn kwaliteit als zanger.
I'm not Dolly Parton, you know, I don't sing that way. But that's one thing I would never take as singing lessons. I mean, it's just not worth it. I'd be the worst person to try to teach singing to.
Is it? Yeah?
Yeah, I'd be hopeless.
Why? Because you're so stubborn?
I couldn't learn it. I couldn't learn how to sing. I don't think I could ever learn how to sing. That would be, because you need a voice in the first place, you know, you need some talent in the first place. So I think I'd be a lost cause that'd have to give me up.
What about commercialism? Do you see it as an enemy or as a friend?
I don't see it as a friend particularly. I've never done anything for a marketplace. I don't use those terms. I don't have many friends in the music business. I have a lot of friends in music, and they're two separate things. The music business now has become more and more corporate and more separate from artists, I think. Because if you can't please yourself, you can't please anybody. You know, you've got to like what you do yourself. There's so many
different worlds. A lot of your fellow or colleague musicians do make music with a message. They make music for the environment, make music for the poor, make music for whatever reason. What kind of message do you have?
Well, I think that it's important to let art, not to let art breathe, so that it can sensitize rather than desensitize. That's all that you ask of it. That it reinforces something positive instead of negative, that it liberates rather than oppresses. That's basically it. That it, you feel that it's been given you something that you didn't have before, that, and then you end up wanting to use it in your life in one way or another.
De zanger, componist en gitarist geeft dus wel een diepere betekenis aan zijn liedjes. De samenwerking met de Dire Straits is alleen voorlopig op de lange baan geschoven. Er volgen nog wel enkele concerten, maar een nieuwe cd zit er vooralsnog niet in. In ieder geval staat Mark Knopfler de komende maanden alleen op het podium.
Ja, en hij, Mark Knopfler, is de komende dagen nog te zien en natuurlijk te horen in Arnhem, Rotterdam en Amsterdam.